Hammer time.
Long weekend hammers. Expectations are big. This is the summer of like reboots, sequels, franchise fatigue after all said and done. But let's talk Alien because that's on deck for us first.
All right, director Ridley Scott, who gave us the first Alien way back in 1979, proves once again that space can be a very scary place. A colony ship goes to a planet. They think they've found paradise, but well, you know the rest. Have a look.
So how does Scott breathe life into this franchise all over again?
Well, what he does is he follows the events of Prometheus from 2012, which was kind of maligned by a lot of critics and fans. It's set 10 years after that one. He brings a lot of the familiar scares, the thrills, chills, and spills of his first installment, so it blends the new direction of the story, which is essentially a prequel to the Alien movie originally, with the traditional scares that we know and love about the franchise and the iconic imagery. You saw the face hugger there. It's got the chest bursters and the classic xenomorphs. Now, Riaz, I'm a huge fan of the franchise. As you know, I have a xenomorph tattoo on my leg. But I have to say, the worst part about this movie is that I don't really care where the story is going after this. However, you have a great cast here. Catherine Waterston, Billy Crudup, Danny McBride, Damien Bashir, who you saw in that clip. They're all working really well together. Competent acting for sure, and it looks gorgeous. I mean, Ridley Scott, he's got the production team behind him, the aesthetic is there, and the visual effects are top-notch. But there is a brilliant Blade Runner-type movie buried in the middle of this one, courtesy of Michael Fassbender, who actually plays two different roles. He plays two robots, and the stuff with him is absolutely brilliant, but I found at times the movie was sort of at odds with itself.
So with all of this, the diehard fans, there's plenty to choose from. If you have never seen an Alien movie, how much backstory do you need going into this?
Oh man, well you certainly need to see Prometheus because it directly relates to the events of that one. It references so many things of that adventure, so you really need to be up to speed on that. And you probably want to brush up on the other Alien movies as well, certainly the first two. In short, I think fans will appreciate this in terms of a standalone installment. It's much more accessible than Prometheus, but like myself, you might feel like you've flown this mission before.
How many hammers?
3 out of 5.
3 out of 5 for the sci-fi genre. What about Young Love and Everything?
Okay, break out the tissues. This is based on the young adult novel of the same name, Everything. A young girl suffering from a rare disease has her confined indoors. She's basically allergic to everything, cannot go outside. She strikes up a romance with the boy next door, played by Jurassic World's Nick Robinson. And she is Amanda Stenberg. She played Rue in The Hunger Games.
Oh.
Here's what you need to know. It's really cheesy. It's got a lot of the cliche writing, but the love story was palpable. It was believable. It was grounded by great performances. And it took an innovative approach to the genre. It didn't actually break any new ground, but I thought it was convincing, it had a lot of heart, it was quite poignant. Despite the plot holes and the cliche dialogue, I actually was engaged the whole time, and it's a brisk 96 minutes.
How many man tears?
He's here.
3 out of 5 man tears. And hammers.
And hammers, too. All right, something for everybody this weekend at the box office.